She's just a girl and she's on fire. Hotter than a fantasy, lonely like a highway. She's living in a world and it's on fire. Filled with catastrophe, but she knows she can fly away. Oh, she got both feet on the ground and she's burning.
A fierce, not taking no for an answer, a go-getter, and a program development specialist. So she's a former policy analyst. She's credited with creating Brooklyn's Task Force on Teen Violence, spearheading HIV advocacy and testing campaigns, working closely with the state agencies and justice reinvestment initiatives, and training over 1,200 Brooklyn youth in work readiness and placing them in real jobs. She continues to work tirelessly to support young people in Brooklyn. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome this year's Civic Leadership Award recipient, Miss Jamila Rose Persaudi.
So I just want to leave two things with you here today. One, I'm not going to tell you about my history or the things that I'm here for being honored, but what I do want to remind everyone here about tonight is many of the New Yorkers who are your neighbors, potentially your cousins, your brothers, your sisters, and even potentially your family members who may be on public assistance, who may be recipients of federal, state, and city grants that help them to develop their work skills, that help them to gain an education, and that help them to be self-sufficient in life. I've noticed at a very early age that the people who typically make policies for us don't look like us, they don't come from where we come from, they don't speak our language, and there's like an intellectualization of culture other than Black culture, which doesn't necessarily mean that they're talented or qualified to be making policies for us. So it's been my job and it's been my role, as I'm in one of the largest social service agencies in the country, to make sure that we're holding people's feet to the fire, that we're designing programs that really help people and lift them out of poverty, and that we ensure that people are getting education that can help them find living wage jobs. I want to leave you with that first thing. Second thing I want to leave you with, because many of you may not know, Census 2020 is coming up, and it doesn't look like anything that we've ever seen before. In 2000, the census was funded with $7 billion. In 2010, it was funded with $14 billion. In 2020, the census is underfunded by 0.5%. Guess whose communities will not be counted? Our communities. So I'm encouraging everyone who's sitting here today to remember in 2020 to go out. You're not gonna get a paper, you're gonna get a card, and you're gonna be doing your census online. It will be digital. Just imagine all the people who will not understand how to do this. I'm encouraging all of you to be active, to be woke, to stand up, not just to run to movie theaters, but to run to the voting booths and the voting polls this November for midterm elections. Thank you very much.